Today, I'm gonna show you how to weld aluminum without a TIG welder and without a MIG welder using these aluminum welding rods from Harbor Freight. Of course, I'll show you the step-by-step process and a few tips I've learned to help make this process a whole lot easier. This kind of welding is called braze welding or brazing. And this kind of aluminum welding is perfect for beginners or even someone who's never even welded before. Let's go over the supplies that we're gonna use for today's project. I'll put an affiliate link for some of these in the description below. And if you use one, it really helps out the channel. You can see here, we've got MAP gas and the torch. This one has a self-igniter. And then I've got a stainless steel wire brush. I've got acetone and paper towels. You can use a file to bevel, or you can use a grinder with a flapper wheel. And then, of course, we have the aluminum welding rods from Harbor Freight. These are called Alumiweld. The aluminum that I'm using for today's project is 1/8 inch thick flat bar. I'm gonna try to braze weld 6-inch long braze welds. To cut my aluminum, I'm gonna be using my chop saw with a carbide blade. Here's a few tips that I've learned along the way. I switched to acetone instead of using alcohol for cleaning my aluminum. The second thing that I've done is I bought a stainless steel wire brush, and I'm only using this for aluminum. Do not use your brush on any ferrous metal because it's gonna contaminate your aluminum. It's gonna ruin your braze weld.
Good gravy.
Now, the type of braze weld that I'm gonna make is a butt weld. And this thing is gonna be 6 inches long. I had a viewer leave a comment and ask, what about doing some longer braze welds? That's a great question. We're gonna try to answer that. So before I try to do this, I am gonna bevel these edges to try to create a little more surface area. To cut these bevels, I'm gonna be using my grinder and a flapper wheel. You could use a file to do this. I'm also making sure I protect my eyes. Now I'm going to clean this thing up with a stainless steel wire brush, and then we're going to wipe it down with the acetone. Here's another tip I've learned about this process. I'm going to be clamping these two pieces down because the thermodynamics of heating this up is really going to move these pieces around. The working temperature of this is just over 700 degrees. We're gonna let this thing cool off and take a close look at it and maybe do a little strength testing. All right, this thing has had a chance to cool off. There's a little paint stuck on there. Let's take a look at the back here. This is really interesting. That is where I really was getting used to the technique better, and I was able to fill that up. Here in the front, it's not quite as full. Let's look at the back side. The back side definitely does not have penetration like a regular weld. And you can see clamping it down really helped to keep this thing nice and flat. So to answer the question, can you do a longer braze weld? Absolutely. I think you could do a braze weld 12 inches long. Just kind of have to get used to the flow and the melt and the technique. Let's see how strong this is. Let's get an up close look at the damage I did with this hammer. You can see on the thicker end here, definitely held up a little bit better. I bent it pretty good. I probably could have got these two pieces apart. Is this structural strength? I don't think so. Could you patch or repair something with this? Absolutely. Let me know your thoughts in the comments down below. And if you're into welding videos, check out my Harbor Freight MIG welding videos. I'm glad you watched, and I hope you'll watch again.